Trade management is very important skill, especially if you're doing short-term swing trading, because a lot of time a trade can make a profit, which gets completely wiped out if you don't do a good job of management. So let's look at one of the examples of yesterday's XON. And if you see, like, it was up pre-market, and based on pre-market, I made a comment saying, look, this is. It has it can easily make another 10%. Buyers can make move crazy amount. So that was like a pre-market, right? So that was one of the stocks which is up 4% plus on 100,000 plus volume in pre-market. So that was like one of the reasons. So now if you look at the zone, here is like zone here, like all the thing which you look for neglected. It wasn't rallying into that news catalyst, and biotechs with a good catalyst can make 20, 25, 30% move. And also I'd looked at like its previous moves. I looked up like here, so it was like 24%. So I looked up here, it was around 20%, I think. The one day before that, if 31% actually. So I had some idea, okay, it will go move 25 to 30%, or 20, so 31% is what it made a move basically. So the first question then becomes, in terms of trade management, okay, how do you enter this? Like, now, how do you enter a trade like this, or whether you get a trade from NTRT, or this was from the morning? How do you enter it? Now, I entered this with a opening a market on open order. So that's an order which you put in before the market opens, and it gets you get a price which is the opening print. So 15.99 is the price, and you don't know what price you're going to get, so you can't really put a stop at that stage. You have to only work on a stop after the trade confirmation has come in, which can take sometimes, if it is a Nasdaq or if it is NYC stock, can be 2, 3 minutes after the open. So and the other thing which you have to remember is, like, if you whenever you're trading NYC stock, is typically whenever there is an opening gap kind of a situation, the stock will open, and immediately within the first 5 minutes there'll be some sort of a shakeout, which a lot of people say that's the market maker trying to make his money. So I knew, okay, look, this stock is going to have a little bit of a shakeout, so you don't immediately like start moving your stop. And it did had a 20, like it opened 15.99, and then it dipped within 2 or 3 minutes. It dipped to 15.77, and then it took off, kind of a thing. Now, here is the thing. Once, like, and I knew once the thing was there, then 40 cents. Less than 15.99, so $16 rounded, so $15.60 is where I put in the initial stop on this particular thing. And if you look at, like, and I don't look at 5 minute chart, but to show it to you, I'm going to show you how this stock moved during that time. During this is the period, if you see, like, this is the period where, and if I can move this to make it look, but like this is the opening print. Okay, and then the stock took off. Okay, so what happens is that immediately, like, I was within like 5 minutes, the stock had gone up around 91 cents. So obviously you're in profit. So I moved my stop to break even, and then kept it at break even till around to immediately, like, within it started moving immediately. So stock was up, like, from the within around 15 or 20 minutes, the stock was almost up $2. Okay, so then the question becomes, look, and how much of that you're willing to give up? Because I knew, look, this kind of moves can be explosive. I was looking at, okay, it can make another dollar or so. So I kept my stop around $1,000 profit protection, and putting $1,000 in risk. Stock started going up, stock started going up, and stock started going up. Now, here is what happened, okay? And I'm not looking at the 5 minute chart when I'm looking at this. I'm just looking at my IB interface. But if you see on this particular, at this particular time frame, okay, the stock crossed over 19, okay? So this cross stocked over 19. So the moment it went over 19, you have to look at, like, based on experience and all, okay, the next logical step is going to be like, quickly going to 19.50 or something like this, and watch the time. This is around 10.25. Here what happens is it gets rejected, it starts coming back. So my first reaction was, at least this is, by this time I have $3,000 plus profit, okay? Because you get it at an opening print, you are looking at around 3,200 or 3,400, I think was the profit at the peak, kind of a thing. So my thing was, this is too much of a profit for this kind of a thing. So I already sold 800 shares. I said, okay, 200 shares, I'll give it more room. I put a 40 cent stop below that, saying if it crosses 19.50, it will keep going. And then it got rejected. And you saw, this got reversed. Like, this is what happens typically. Like, there are some prices around 1950 or 220, stock tries to go, and then it reverses, kind of a thing. And I got stopped out on those 200 shares, net net making around 3,276 or some odd dollars on that trade, which lasted only around this thing, around an hour or less than an hour, 9:32 by 9:32. So, and you see, when I sold my thing, I said, I made a note. This is 10:32. John might be time to move to very tight stop to protect profit or scale out. So this is 10:32 when I wrote. By that time, I had already sold 800 shares. Once it crossed 19, I sold and moved my stop to protect on rest of it. And by the time I finished that post, it had reversed. More or less, it has reversed. And you'll see that. Then I made another comment saying, okay, this is why you need to protect profit. Now, yes, XON did come back later in the day. I was not there in the later in the day move and all, and it did make a new high. After that, it went up, I think, up to 1990 or 1994, almost up to 20. Okay, but that was not the objective. The objective is very clearly on these kind of plays, which are muse plays. Okay, you try to capture the fastest part of the move, and the trade management allowed me to do it. How did I do? First, get in, say, even a stock like this, if I'm going to enter, okay, I'm not going to be waiting for it to set up a 5 minute chart or 10 minute chart, because by that time it's too late. Like, say, if you take that yesterday's example, 5 minutes, what are you going to know? By the 5 minutes, the stock was up 91 cents. So it's too late. Or if you enter here, already by that time the stock was up almost $17. So that's $1, more than $1. It was 15.99 was the opening print, I think. So you're talking about almost losing $1 on the trade. So from a trade management perspective, if you have a news play and if you have very high conviction, or if you think that it is going to make a big move, I knew this, if it starts going down after it opens, say 50 cents below where I bought, or 60 cents, I was going to dump it anyway. If it goes, it was going to go up $2 to $3, and which is what ended up happening. It went up around $3. It faded later. Okay, so enter with a opening price order. That is, if you the risk is that you don't know where it will open. Sometimes it can open and just reverse. And then after that, the first stop was 60, 40 cents below that. That was like in a 16 point, that was like in a 15.40. Then once it went up $2, then I said, okay, I'm willing to move the stop. I moved the stop to at least in a product 1,000. Then I started watching it very closely. I didn't take any trade because of this particular trade, because I said, okay, this is 2,000 now already. It can make another, whatever it can, 1,000. So let's just focus on this. And net net, after it really went up, it is not like, and I was like, and if I trailed, I would have made $2,600 probably. Instead of that, I said, okay, 19 it crosses, let's just dump 800 shares out of 1,000, and on 200, let's put a very close stop. I moved my stop and I got closed out, and that's how trade management happens. So this is a real life example of trade management as to what you can do to protect profit, because especially these kind of moves which happen every day, news related, they can be significantly profitable, but they can end up giving you a lot of, like this particular trade. Again, I did this trade that particular day. If you look at it from the opening print to the total, like the stock was up around $9 or something. And then if you just like used trailing stop or something, you would have got out much better on this trade, I think. And if I remember, I'm just trying to remember from memory, I made around 6,400 or something on this particular trade. But poor trade management would have left you with no profit, because in next 3 days, you don't know this is going to happen, and this is wishing that it will happen. If you get a 9, 6, 7, 8, 9 dollars profit after, like, then you have to move the stop aggressively. So from a trade management point of view, basically, first is your opening stop, in the sense where you're going to put a stop. Most of the time, I'm trying to look at not losing more than $400 or $500 on a trade. So I'm trying to look at that kind of a stop for a 1,000 shares position. And once it is up, like, say, 1,000 shares, $1,000, that's like, if I put a stop of 40 cents, $400 is at risk. So if you have $1,000, you're looking at 2.5 hour. So basically, and sometimes that happens within few minutes, so it's just a question of moving your stop. So at that stage, I would definitely try and protect 600, then use trailing stop. Or most of the time, I would use trailing stop much later in the day, kind of a thing. I have found that it is better to sell into strength. So I will always try and peel up a position, sell, like, say, 600 shares or 700 shares, then sell another 100, then sell 100, and then on the remaining, put a trailing stop. If my trailing stop is, say, to protect 40 cents, if the stock still keeps going vertically, like it keeps going too rapidly, then I will make my trailing stop 30 cents. I'll move my trailing stop 25 cents, because you want to protect as much as possible from the trade. And especially this becomes very important for these nighttime, right time kind of trade, because if you look at this particular stock also on this particular day, if you look at that particular on a range basis, the stock would have made $4-$5 range. Like $5 range, right? And but, like, if you just sat there, see, you don't know this is going to happen. The trade may not have worked out. That 1 day profit itself was a very big profit. Or even if you look at something like Roku, which is like made a big move, and second day it reversed and then ended up almost giving up almost that kind of a gain. These are kind of trades where trade management becomes very important. For a trade management perspective, one, what kind of orders you're going to use to get into it. I found opening gap order, OPG as it is called in IB, or market on open as it is called in Fidelity, is the best way to get in, because that guarantees you're going to get the opening print. Like in this case, I was not waiting. I knew I'm going to get a guaranteed print at the open. So that's, and you get guaranteed fill also. Like if you put an order for 1,000 shares, you get filled for 1,000 shares. Okay. Then if it is especially if it is a stock which is like NYSE, it is going to have some sort of a checkout in the first 5 minutes. That's very typical of those. So you have to, like, let that checkout play out a little bit, and then put your stop. I think on Signet also the same thing happened. Like, say, it shook out. It actually had a bigger checkout than this, but that's you have to factor that in if you're getting into something like NYSE stock. Okay. And then once it starts taking off, most of the time a good NTRT is profitable in the first 5-10 minutes itself. Then it's just a question of moving your stop to protect. Like, once it is up $1,000, $2,000, I'm very clear. I'm not going to let it have come down and wipe out my $2,000. I'm willing to give it a room of 40 cents or $1,600 I want to protect. I'll let it go. If it goes, say, $3,000, then I'm not even willing to go and say, okay, look, I'm going to willing to give up 400 out of it. Like, I move my stop to 20 cents. And if I feel that, look, this is not as sustainable, I sell into that strength and keep a smaller position, and on that smaller position, keep trailing. So trailing stop, I started using more and more now. And that's how you protect profit, or that's how you protect your things on the trade. So this is one example of how you can manage trade to make sure that whatever profit you have doesn't vanish. And XON, which is like, which made a big move yesterday. And biotechs, if you study biotechs, typically 25 to 30% moves, and sometimes even more than that, are very much given, especially if it has a high short interest. And this had a high short interest. So trade management, if you are going to be doing swing trading, becomes very critical, because you need very aggressive trade management. If you are going to be doing a longer term kind of a trading, you just like in a buy, say something like, let's say, I'm trying to think of an example, better example to give you just now, say, let's say for sake of like, just don't go and buy it now, it is no more a buy. Like, here is a stock which I bought, okay, and I put a stop here because it was in a longer term position, and I didn't move my stop, I moved my stop here, and then like a couple of days ago I moved my stop here, okay. Now that's like in a very slow kind of a thing, or like an, I taken a recently, a couple of days ago, I taken a position in Bank of America in a longer term accounts. Now my stop is here, okay, and I didn't move it because it came down and all. Now if it goes up from this consolidation for a couple of weeks, or like, and it makes 5% move, then I might move my stop to below somewhere where this consolidation is, and slowly move the stop. So for longer term position, you move your stop very, very slowly. And once they become profitable, like say in this particular case, I'm not willing to give up my profit below this level. Okay, if it makes more, then I want more. But like, that's for a large stock, this is a lot of profit. 15% is a lot of profit. So that's how you manage your positions, basically, or manage trades. And I'll give you, show you more examples of this as and when trade happens, because it's best to learn from existing situations and how to manage that situation. So XON was an example of a good trade management. This was an example of a bad trade management. In this particular thing, I was already profitable, and I let it like a hit with a loss, which was a poor trade management, because at least if I had moved the stop to break even, I would not have had to give up the any, I would not have lost any money, because the stock was up on this. If you look at that particular day, it went up like this, and the stop should have been moved at least to protect that much amount of profit. But I was thinking more like 3 days and all swing trade, so that's why. So that's my lesson on trade management using a latest example.